Well, the Cleveland Public Library started in 1869, and it was largely the result of a law passed in 1867 that gave school boards the right to ask the voters for tax levies to support free libraries. And Reverend Anson Smythe, who was the superintendent of the Cleveland schools at that time, was really the champion, and the voters overwhelmingly supported, and that first tax levy to support a free library happened, and 5,800 books were bought and started being circulated. This free library started as an investment by taxpayers.
Cleveland Public Library has always been a library of first, so we were the first library to open up our shelves. Originally, folks would come into the library, write down what they were interested in getting. The library would take the note, walk back into the stacks, find the book that they had asked for, and then bring it back to them. We were the first big library of our size to decide that we trusted our community, and so we opened up shelves. That really came from William Howard Brett, who was, you know, a trailblazer as far as first and library science. So he was the first to actually create a separate space where children could go and have a floor where they could receive services and receive books. Cleveland Public Library stepped up and started providing services for the blind, one of the first libraries across the country to do that.
The library as we know it today at its current location at 325 Superior opened in 1925. Many members of the community flocked to the library and utilized it as a great resource, the free resources that were made available and viewed as a safe haven.
As film became something you could circulate that people could borrow, we had a film bureau. As science became so critical, we really were the public access to the developments in science and industry. And then as we get into the 50s and things, all those post-war items were the first big book clubs. As we get into the 60s and 70s, you can't talk about the Cultural Revolution or the anti-war movement. The library is the place with the history, the context, the breadth of unbiased sharing of information.
And as we worked with our partners in the county, some of them started talking to us about how could we benefit from working with the Cleveland Public Library. We started building what became ClevNet, a small consortium at that point in time, and then built it to today where we have over 43 library systems in Northern Ohio who work with us. As services were modernized, so was the face of the library itself. The Lewis Stokes Wing was dedicated in 1997, adding much needed space and more than 30 miles of shelf space.
The implementation of the e-books actually took place during the time that Andrew Venable was the director. That really was historic because it took us to a place, once again, where Cleveland Public Library could be a trailblazer. The creation of Tech Central here at the main library, it's enabled the library to come alive, if you will, in a different way. The availability of laptops, of various tech toys, if you will. We have a 3D printer. That's innovation, in my mind, at its best. We care what they think about the library and its services, and we're interested in knowing what they want us to be as we move ahead. That we're not just trying to plan a library that's sustainable for the future based on what we think they need, but we want to know what they would like us to become to meet their needs.
Today, under the leadership of Felton Thomas Jr., we celebrate the history, progress, and promise of the People's University.